everyone. It's back to be on the beach, and I'm always on the beach, even if I'm not on the beach. Well, today I'm in somebody's, bar area. I just rolled up here and sat down, and apparently you can do that kind of stuff on this beach. So what I want to talk to you about today is how I manage uncertainty. Now, I don't know if I quit my job more so than I was kicked out of my job. But whatever the situation was, thank God that I got out of that JOB space that just overbroke, that, living paycheck to paycheck, working hard around the clock, running around trying to get all these reports done. I have to do this, I have to do that, I have to sit on this committee, I have to sit on that committee, I have to do this, I have to do that. You know, all of that came to a screeching halt when I was basically fired. I mean, I don't care what they call it, contract ended, whatever, we don't want you anymore. I was working for an HBCU and basically I didn't fit in. And I didn't fit in for many reasons, and thank God that my supervisor or boss or whatever the thing is saw it in her infinite wisdom to harass me and bully me so much so that I ended up not having that job anymore. But as a result of not having that job, I decided to live authentically, meaning I love the beach. I think about the beach. I always think about the beach. When I'm at the beach, I feel great. I feel calm. I feel a sense of peace. I could think about life. I could think about what I want to do. I could think about everything that's good and positive about my life. So thank God. Shout out to the people who fired me. Thank God. So here I am. And I think the question that I get most often is, how do you do it? How do you do this thing? Well, I really don't have a recipe. I don't really have a rhyme. I don't have a reason. What I do have is information. And one piece of information, something that I've learned along the way, is once you take yourself off of artificial time, meaning the clock, the 24-hour clock, the 12-year calendar, the alerts, the bells, the whistles, you have to be here at this time, do this at this time. Once you take yourself out of that domain and place yourself on natural time, which is based on the 13 moon cycle and also serendipity and synchronicity. I think that's the bigger word, is synchronicity. Things happen in my life, they just happen. And they happen beautifully. They happen in ways that I can't ever even plan. So let me tell you about my weekend. So basically, I had this awesome weekend, a weekend that I could have never planned in a million years. And this is what had happened. So I came out to make a video. And it was so hot. And I hurried up and finished the video. And I shut it off. And I didn't save it. And I got home. And I was like, oh, it's a disaster. I just wasted my time. I got all sweaty. And I don't even have a video. What I realized is that I had forgotten my cup out here. And I'd gone to another beach to enjoy life and have fun and think and meditate and strategize and plot and plan, you know, whatever I do on the beach. And so I said to myself on the way home, I wonder if my cup is still there. And so we drove past this place and lo and behold, my cup was still sitting there. So I'm like, okay, I'm going to go get my cup. Not only that, I'm going to remake that video. But it was dark, so I'm like, okay, I can see what I can do. So when I got here, the owner of this establishment was sitting here, and he invited me to chit-chat. I said, oh, no, I'm just here to get my cup, and I'm here to make a video, and then I'm out. So after I finished my video, I said, okay, thank you, nice to meet you, blah, blah. And, you know, Bahamians are very hospitable, and they love to invite you in, and they love to show you that Bahamian hospitality. So once again, he invited me to sit down, which I did, and I kind of sat over there. And, you know, he had a friend that was visiting from Nassau. And, you know, they're usually curious as to what an American is doing here. Well, I'm not really American, but I'm here nonetheless. So I started telling my story about how, you know, I quit my job, or, You know, I got fired, and here I am working, teaching, living from the beach. And he says, wow, that's amazing. I can't believe you're actually doing that. I'm an accountant, and he has this big accountant firm in Nassau, and he's doing great. He's successful. But it looked to me that he's kind of uptight. Like, how could you have fun and enjoy life when you're that uptight? So I'm like, okay. So I'm just listening to this gentleman and listening to the things that he's saying and thinking just how much of that stuff I believed myself when I was working and caught up in the rat race and the schedules and the this and the that. And my days are booked out for months in advance and, you know, everything, you know, is planned out. No. So he asked me, well, how did you do it? How did you go from being this university professor to being on the beach? I said, well, I gave up a lot of stuff. I said, it's all about sacrifice and taking a good look at your life and seeing what's in it that really can go. And so that's what I did. I gave up everything. I told him I sold my Rolex. I gave back the Benz, you know, got rid of the houses, sold stuff, gave away stuff, you know. And he said, wow, that's amazing. I said, yeah. And he said to me later on in the conversation, he goes, well, do you ever regret any of that? Do you ever miss it? Do you ever miss the fancy this, the Rolex, the this and that? And I said, you know, absolutely not. I said, do you know what I got in exchange for giving up that Rolex? And he says, what? I said, I get to sit here with you. I get to spend time with you. I get to talk with you. I get to, for one moment in time, to sit here on this island and meet someone so interesting and have a beautiful conversation. I think that's worth a Rolex. What do you think? And he said, yes, absolutely. I see what you're talking about now. So sometimes we have attachments to these objects, these status symbols, these things that we think are the markers of our academic and career-wise success. You know, if you're not pushing a Benz, a Beamer, have the big fancy house, can go vacation here, the kids are in private school, blah, blah. I'm not saying, you know, I'm not hating on any of those things. I've done many of those things. You know, I've achieved many of those things. And I'm all for people living the life that they want to lead. But for me, my life was going in a totally different direction and I wasn't going with it. So it was this pull and push and pull, like, I want to go to the beach, but I have this document to upload, or I have to finish this report. I want to relax, but I have to get all dressed up in this tight, you know, I call it a tight power suit, because I never felt good in it. I always felt restricted, no matter, even if it was the perfect size, I always felt like, why do I have to put this on? So I have my bikinis, and I live in bikinis. My entire wardrobe is bikinis, tank tops, and leggings, and long dresses. I love long dresses. So do I have any regrets on this walk? No. Do I have uncertainty? Yes. Can I plan my life myself? No. I can have strong intentions about what I want. But let me tell you a little bit more about the weekend. So the weekend went on, and in addition to having this fabulous conversation, I get an invite for myself and my children to go out on a boat the next day to a private island to snorkel, to chill, to relax, to sit in the water, to meditate, to breathe, to open some chakras, to really live life and enjoy my the company of my friends. And guess what? I didn't pay a dime. Not one dime came out of my pocket. Now, normally when people go on vacation and they want to take a trip like this, it's probably about $150, $185 per person. You have to sign all these waivers. You have to pay this fee, that fee, the VAT, whatever the case may be. But when you're living life this way and you're allowing things to happen, you're allowing abundance to come into your life, you're allowing beautiful people to come into your life, this is how it happens. You get things. So normally a trip like this would have probably cost you about $500, maybe more, for an entire, you know, day out and food and the whole nine. I didn't pay a dime. Simply because I'm in a place that I want to be, that's energizing my soul, that's giving me life, And so the things that I want are naturally attracting to me. And that would never happen sitting in a boardroom, sitting in a conference room, going, ha, 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 ha. Oh, I don't agree with you. Well, I agree with you. Ha, ha, ha. What's on the agenda? Can we, ha, ha, ha. You know, when I was doing that, I wasn't happy. I mean, I was running the show. You know, people listened to me, heads rolled. But, you know, I was unhappy. Right now, I get to sit and chill on a beautiful beach, meet people, meet myself, strategize, think, be free. And did I say meet interesting people? I think my life is so wealthy because I get to meet interesting people. And my daughter says, I like to talk. I talk to a lot of people. Yes, I like to talk. And that's what I do. That's my special talent and gift. I like to talk and people like to listen. So, hey, it works out. So to wrap this up a little bit, to tell you, if you're on this journey, if you started, if you're thinking, if you quit the job, and you're like, oh, snap, what next? Just be encouraged to know that I am not planning any of this. It is unfolding. And the more I allow and reduce my anxiety and like, oh my God, I need to know what's going to happen. Who's going to take me to the airport? What's, you know, who's going to pick me up? When are we going to get to the beach? When are we going to get off the beach? How many times are we going to go to the beach? Do you have the sunblock? Do you, you know, I don't worry about any of that because I know God got me. I got me. God got me. This beach got me. And so the world is a safe place. It's a beautiful place. It's an abundant place. It's a place where I can feel free. And I want you to experience this too. So join me on my journey. You can find me at www.drbonthebeachtv.com. That's my YouTube channel. You can find me on Instagram at Dr. B on the Beach. Also, I have my new Patreon. It's up and running. And you can support me on Patreon so I can bring to you more beach videos and more tips and insights on how to walk this walk, how I'm doing it. And if I can inspire you to do the same, then so be it. I'll make more videos. I'll share more tips. However, if you join me on one of the Patreon groups, I will have so much inside information, so many secret jewels that I will share with you, perks. You can get discounts on merch, on this, on that. Just join me on Patreon. I'm Dr. B on the Beach on Patreon. Check it out. And there'll be links at the end of this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And also click the bell so that you can see when I go live and check out all my videos. This is Dr. B on the Beach, helping you have a glorious life. Peace.